बुद्ध्यबोध्यमुद्ध्यदुर्घितमुपानुसंवेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमः तदेवाहन्नमत्त निश्चितामतिः Sorry for the delay. I had quite a disturbed sleep, you know, throughout the night. I was dreaming, at least that's what it felt like. So Swapnavastha is working well. The discussion on Swapnavastha, I'm having a lot of dreams and remember them as well. So as a meditative activity, and for everyone, those who want to try this, those who meditate, you can use this, you know, have Swapna. If as soon as you wake up, if you have a good memory of details of any swapna, be it a good swapna or a nightmare also, you know that it is false. So mithyatva nischaya is there when you are woken up. Then you spend some time in analyzing each and every detail of the swapna and see how you felt during that experience, that anubhava, as a dreamer. So as a dreamer, the anubhava is as intense as it is in jagrat avastha. Therefore, there is no difference between the two. It will help us understand clearly as to how I am the continuing entity across the various states, whereas the swapna prapancha along with the dreamer is mithya. Nama Rupatmaka. Anubhava, intense Anubhava, where I feel that I cannot change anything. On waking up, I feel that I cannot change anything in the dream. I didn't choose this dream. No, you didn't choose this Jagrat Prapancha also. You have no control over what are the circumstances, at least in this Janma. The circumstances are created by your own karma in the earlier Janma, along with the other's karma as well, which is fructifying now. So you had a say in the kind of prapancha, but right now you don't get to choose what comes about when, which is the same case in dream also. But I am in control in the waking state. I don't have any control. I can't act out anything as per my wishes in the dream. Is a thinking of a waker from the waking perspective about the dreamer. But as a dreamer, you know that you had control then. In that avastha, you had as much kartrutva, as much free will as you have now. So if you analyze this, it helps. And this is how the journey in Vichara Sagara also started. All three brothers went to the Guru. And the question was, how do we get Mukti? Because their father has got Jnana. He has left everything lock, stock, barrel. Now, the elder brother understood when the first answer was given. What was that? The first answer was very simple. He says, everything is imagined in you. Who is this? His question was what? To whom is this prapancha visible? Who is the creator? All these questions were put together by the elder brother. So you have to see the difference in questions also to see the adhikarityam. And what methodology will work, what methodology of teaching might work to lead yourself to jnana. So initial teaching was based on the question itself. The question was, how do I get mukti? What is this prapancha? Who created it? And who sees this? The Guru gave an answer. It is you who are seeing it. It is imagined in you. You are the karta. Then he had some questions which were answered, follow-on questions, and then he moved on. The second brother had a question as to how can this mithya guru and mithya Shruti lead to moksha. And his question start there because he had Shraddha lacking now. So the teaching went on with Karya Karana Prakriya, etc. And then that chapter was closed. Second was free. The third has questions about how Swapna can be the example with which you lead yourself to Jagrat Mithyatvam. So he thinks that Swapna is also real because Jagrat Avastha is real, Jagrat Padarthas are real. Therefore, Swapna is either a Smriti of Jagrat Prapancha Padarthas, whereby it becomes real, or he said that the Sukshma Sharira travels outside and therefore it is real. Now, in all this discussion, the third brother has so many questions. Tarka Drishti has so many questions. So, Tarka is necessary there. There are quite a few people who set the Tarka Shastra aside, who set the Darshana aside. Tarka has Darshana section and there is a systematic analysis. Now, when two people are discussing, there has to be some commonality. Between Astikas, it is Shruti. Unfortunately, in Astika Darshanas also, except for Advaita Vedantin, everyone considers Tarka as Pradhana in one way or the other. Therefore, in discussion, one has to use Tarka. Now, one may say that I don't discuss with others, I don't care. But the Bhashyadi Granthas are Manana Granthas. If they are Manana Granthas, then you don't need some other Purva Paksha outside. You are the Purva Paksha. Your mind is throwing questions. If we didn't have questions, we would have been free with the first example of Swapna, that Prapancha is Kalpita. Oh, it can be Kalpita. So you go from Asambhava to Sambhava, and then it is but impossible that the Prapancha is Mithya. It is not possible that Prapancha is Satya, it has to be Mithya. So that is what you land from. So you go from Asambhava to Sambhava, and then you say that the earlier Asambhava seems Asambhava now. So that the Prapancha cannot be Mithya, it is Satya. Then you say that, oh, it can be possibility that Prapancha can be Mithya. And then, oh, Prapancha has to be Mithya, it cannot be Satya. This is the journey. If we have not landed there, then we have to use any prakriya. Now, if there are so many questions, you cannot say, oh, no, I'll not study Tarka Shastra. Then what basis do you have to discuss with yourself also? In Manana, you need some process. It may be having its flaws, but you still need a process to answer the question. It seems logical to me. It appears logical. Is meaningless. It has to be logical. Not only for you, for when you discuss with others, if you are explaining to others, there should be a methodology. Shruti just does not say this is how it is. If it is so, it just tells you it is so. But for one to accept it, it's a tall order. In mathematics also, E equal to MC square. No, I don't think it is possible. Our thinking has no meaning there. It does not appear so. You study mathematics as taught by the mathematicians to understand what is E equal to MC square. And if you understand what is E, what is M, what is C square, what is C in that? So to know energy, mass and the speed of light, you have to study from physicists. You cannot say, oh, I understand what this equal is, but then this equal to symbol, I don't think it is working with E on one side and MC square on the other. It won't work because you do not have the basis of physics. So you need Shruti also and you need Tarka also. If you have questions, that is the only way to resolve. No, I have my own thinking. That own thinking does not work. That is why we are here. That is why we have been continuing in samsara. So some basis is needed. Vyakrana is needed. Some basic Vyakrana is needed. Some basic Tarka is needed. Otherwise, it is not possible. Any Tarka that you have, if you think it is sufficient and it has not worked, then there is need for Tarka. But the issue is a little more complicated than that. If you start studying Tarka, Tarka is very addictive. Because for an intellectual, one who is having so many questions, it becomes tasty and then one sets aside Advaita and gets trapped in the Shruti itself, which is the case with Vyakrana also. Vyakrana also gets tasty if you go to Sutra level. Those people who have mathematical inclinations or a logical mind, Vyakrana becomes addictive. Then you start studying Vyakrana. If you study Vyakrana's philosophy, that is good enough. Also, Spotavada, because it is very close to Advaita. But if you get lost in sutras, why, which sutra is applying? You go to the meaning. If you understand the meaning, you understand how this formation is prakriya and the prakriti and pratyaya, then it's sufficient to understand the meaning, you move on. But if you know which sutra applies in each and every case, then in Vedanta, you lose sight of Vedanta. Similarly, in Tarka also. But Tarka, you should not focus on the darshana, you should focus on the debate aspect. It is complex, but then everything is complex in the beginning. You know, I was just looking through some edit work of Panchadashi by Swami Paramarthananji. He says that even Tattva Bodha was difficult when you started. See how far you have come in so many years. So everything is difficult. One has to have commitment, not losing sight of the goal. So that is the idea here when we are looking at this chapter, because there are questions, you know. People say, why, you know, why so much of Tarka in Vichara Sagara? Vichara Sagara has Tarka, but it does not use Navya Nyaya. Mostly it uses simple language. Tippanakara has some Navya Nyaya, but then it is simple Tarka language-wise. Tarka is complicated, but language is simpler than the Tarkika's language. Tarkika's language proper. So this is needed as Manana. So Athava. What was said is that Prane Shariraad Anirgate Antak, not this. Yeah, we saw this. So Tasma Sukshma Sangatasya Raja Iva Prana Iva Pradhana, and therefore Prane Shariraad Anirgate Antakkarana Jnanendriyani Cha Na Bahirgacheyu. The indriyas which facilitate jnana and prana which doesn't facilitate jnana but facilitates kriya, without prana indriyas cannot, that those indriyas cannot function without prana at all. They cannot travel itself, let alone function outside. The travel itself won't be possible. Therefore, the second possibility of Sukshma Sharira traveling outside and seeing the real Padarthas in Swapnavastha is invalidated. Athava, another way to look at it is, Athava Antakkaranam Jnanendriyani Cha Bhutanam Sattva Guna Karyani Atastesham Jnana Shakti Rasti Na Kriya Shakti. So Antakkarana is created out of Sukshma Panchamahabhutas, but what part of the which guna is contributing? There we know that it is Sattva Guna. So being Sattva Guna Karya, the Antakarana and Jnanendriyas have Jnana Shakti. Sattva is Jnana Karaka. For Kriya you need Rajas. Therefore, Tesham Indriyanam Jnana Shakti Rasti Natu Kriya Shakti. Pranasya Tu Kriya Shakti Rasti. Prana has Kriya Shakti. It is Rajoguna Karya. Pranasya Kriya Shakti Valadeva Marana Samaye Linga Shariram Stulam Idam Shariram Vihaya Lokantaram Gachati. So I have explained this earlier yesterday. So we can go faster because these points are covered. They are in detail now. So in during Marana, what happens at the Marana Samaya? The Sukshma Sharira has to go to another Loka or another Sharira. So it has to leave this Stula Sharira. Therefore, Prana helps that process. Prana helps the kriya. Which kind of kriya? Of leaving the earlier body, earlier stula sharira. The current stula sharira, not earlier, the current stula sharira. Prana balena eva indriya dvara antakkarana vrittir bahir ghatadi desham gacchati. And while one is alive, then to have ghatavritti, patavritti ityadi, when the indriya travels outside, that is also due to prana alone. Without prana, indriya cannot travel to the ghatadi desha. So chakshur indriya cannot see if it cannot travel to ghata. Prana sahayam vina antakkaranadikam navhirgantum prabhavati. And therefore these indriyas and entire sukshma sharira which needs prana, whether the person is alive or dead, in both cases prana has the play. Therefore, prana sahayam vina, without prana's help, antakkaranadikam bahirgantum na prabhavati. There is no possibility that in swapna, the sukshma sharira, jnanendriyas, travel outside. That is not possible. Atayeva yoga shastra uchyate. So, yoga shastra says, because yoga shastra has analyzed a lot of this. We have to take help from wherever it is available in those their particular areas of expertise. You cannot say that I am the expert in everything. Advaitin does not say that I am an expert in everything. Advaitin says that I have understood the Shruti's commitment. What does the Shruti's want to say? What does the Shruti want to say? In totality, I know the Tatpari of the Shruti. And that is all that is needed for moksha. But if there are sections where something which we do not know is talked about, Karma Kanda, Dhyana section, Upasana section, something about the mind, how the mind functions, then we have to take help from their own expert areas. I mean, whoever is expert in it, those subject experts, we have to take perspective of subject experts. So in Karma Kanda, the expert is with Purva Mimamsaka. In the creation, tattvas, when they are created, that detail is very well analyzed by Sankhyas. So we take help from them. When the antakarana, how it functions, what exactly happens, what is the vritti, all this, these ideas are analyzed well by the yogika and the dhyana process also. How concentration is possible, etc. There we use help from the yoga shastra. Then the nyaya vaisheshikas, we take help from for discussing with all of these. Definitely for Nastikas, you cannot use Shastra example. For Nastikas, Jainas and Buddhas, how do you discuss with them? You cannot say that because Shruti says so, so you need Tarka. There you definitely need it. And to discuss with others also, you need Tarka. So Tarka and Vyakrana. Vyakrana is needed for everything. All of these, including Nastikas, they need Vyakrana. Whichever language you use, Vyakrana is needed. So Vyakrana and Tarka are Anugraha Karaka for all darshanas. They are the basis without which you cannot start off. Even in your own analysis, you can't start off without understanding the language and without seeing connections across sentences and across chapters. So you need some level of tarka. Now we take help from yoga to understand, or we say they have analyzed it, so we agree with them. So therefore it is quoted. Atayeva yoga shastra uchyate. It is shastra. Yoga is not something else. It is not ashastra. It is shastra. It is not ashastrika. It is shastra. So yoga shastra uchyate. Prana nirodham vina mano nirodho na siddhyati. If you need control over manas, you cannot say that I will not do pranayama. It may work with, you know, oh, my buddhi is, I will control it. Does it work? The monkey mind keeps on jumping. How does it work? It will work. That is why even in the Vedantic Dhyana, the teacher may laugh out at Yoga Shastra's conclusion, but still will use Pranayama. Even the teachers who, you know, in Advaita, who do not have anything to do with Yoga and Samadhi, they will also teach Pranayama. Why? Because without that, your mind will not be controlled. Can you have, you know, you for a Dhyana, for a class, meditation class, you cannot go running and say that, okay, let me meditate. Your breath is totally out of place. You need control over your breath. This prana, which helps the kriya shakti, if prana is jumpy, the kriya will be jumpy, even the subtle kriya will be jumpy. It will be jerky. So your mind will be jumping more. Because rajas has taken over. You need sattva pradhanattvam for dhyana. How will it become sattva pradhana? By regulating the flow of breath. This we have to learn from. So you cannot say, no, I know pranayama. You cannot know pranayama. You cannot do bhastrika when you are wanting to do meditation. Immediately before meditation. You can do it earlier and then regulate the flow with whatever, you know. But prana sahayam is needed even for dhyana. Atayeva yoga shastri uchyate prana nirodham vina mano nirodhana siddhyati. You cannot have prana running around and say that mind is still. Mind will be running around. Therefore, prana sancharanena manasa sancharanam bhavati, prana nirodhan mano nirodho bhavati. Now the flip side is also true. just mentioning it, because in Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi talks about this as the prana and manas are like the two, you know, sub branches of a branch of a tree. You know, as kids, if you cannot reach a particular, you know, if you played around and you try to pull a branch of the tree, your hand does not reach there, whether it's a flower or a fruit. If it doesn't reach one part of the branch, but you can reach the other part of the branch, you pull that sub branch. Let's say it's a mango tree, you are trying to pull down a mango. You cannot reach the mango, but you can reach the other part of the branch which is connected to the branch which is holding the mango. Then you can pull that and the mango comes down. That part of the sub-branch, that sub-branch also comes down, that part of the branch. So Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says that the prana and manas are the two sub-branches of a tree's branch. If you pull down one, the other will come down. So if you pull down the mango, the other will also come down. So let's say you can reach one mango, but there are two mangoes on the other side. So you pull one mango, but you also want the other two. They will also come down. If you pull down the two mangoes, that third one, you know, dangling on, which you cannot reach, that will also come down. So prana regulation brings the regulation of the mind. And the flip side is that, let's say there is a lot of kriya going on, which is prana's effect. Your breath is out of place. So the doctor is going to look at, why is your breath not normal? So he says, you breathe, you are unable to breathe properly. So there is a lot of, that is why, you know, when you are angry, that time your prana is all over the place. How do you control it? There you see, you know, you start counting. So you control your mind. If you control your mind, your prana will come under control. Krodha will come under control. Kriya Shakti will come under control. When you use your sattva, you can control the Kriya Shakti, Rajas also. So both ways, they have dependency on each other. But in this case, what is shown is that if you control the prana, then manas is controlled. So prana sancharaneyo manasa sancharanam bhavati. Only when prana moves, the mind can move. Prana nirodhan mano nirodho bhavati. Therefore, pranayama is the preceding step before pratyahara in yoga shastra also. Prana nirodha will lead to mano nirodha. So therefore, prana nirodhan mano nirodho bhavati iti cha yoga shastre uchyate. Ataha mano nirodha rupa rajayogam anushthatum icchan prana nirodha rupa hatayogam anutishthet. So even a person who wants rajayoga being samadhi, person who wants samadhi, that person cannot say, I'll not use everything, you know, I'll not use hata. If samadhi takes place, well and good, I will just do some kind of activity. That won't work. Okay, we have a new kind of background sound. Somebody has speakers on. Ane, so ataha mano nirodha rupa raja yogam anushthatum icchan. One who wants that samadhi dhyana, that kind of yoga, which is mano nirodha rupa. Mano nirodha is chitta nirodha. Chitta vritti nirodha is samadhi yoga. That person has to do the earlier angas, which are what? Prana nirodha rupa hata yogam anutishthet. He has to follow the earlier anga. You cannot say that I'll need dharana dhyana samadhi. I will follow dharana dhyana samadhi. But that person will not have pratyahara itself. Dharana itself will be impossible, let alone dhyana and samadhi. But if a person has iccha for dharana dhyana samadhi, pratyahara is necessary, which will convert the bahiranga to antaranga. Bahirangas are yamaniyama. Then yamaniyamas are common for everyone in every sadhana. It is needed. Without that, it is not possible. You have to follow a process and you have to restrict yourself from some things, deny yourself some things. That is yamaniyama. But asana pranayama are the next two angas. So asana pranayama is there for this very reason, that prana nirodha rupa hatha yogam anutishthet. And hatha yoga includes the asana also there. But specifically, prana nirodha. To do prana nirodha also, you have to, you cannot be, you know, moving around. So you have to have some asana. Sukham sthiram asanam, you need something which is easily accomplishable, and then prana nirodha is needed, which will lead to mano nirodha. Anena api hetuna antakarnasya gamanam pranadhinam bhavati. So it has established that Yoga Shastra also says it. Without prana control, you cannot have manas control. Then for travel of manas also, prana is needed. Then how do you say that prana can stay back in the stula sharira and swapnavastha and let the manas go outside? That won't happen. Therefore, prane bahir anirgate antakarnam yanendriyane chana bahir gacheyuhu. This is what is established earlier also. The same proposition is concluded with a different reasoning, different way of reasoning. Swapnavasthayam stula shariram prana sahitam eva drishyate. In swapna, do you have prana or not? You say that you have left behind prana in the stula sharira, says the Siddhanti. Have you left behind prana and are without prana in the swapnavastha? The dreamer has his own prana. Does he or does he not have prana? We don't care whether it is the same prana or different prana. It may be an imagined prana, but prana is needed. Is prana there? Is the dreamer breathing or not? Swapnavastham stula shariram prana sahitam eva drishyate. Outside you have left it, but the prana is there in stula sharira. Atascha swapne antakkaranam bahirgatva satyapadarthan vishayikaroti iti etan na sambhavati. I'm just jumping the gun. So in there is prana, even in the swapnavastha you have prana. Here what is being talked about is in swapnavastha. The context is the without prana, sukshma sharira cannot travel outside. And what is established here is that without prana, the jnanendriyas themselves cannot travel outside. And what is said is that third point made there in the same context is that swapnavasthayam stula shariram prana sahitam eva drishyate. The stula sharira has prana because somebody who is watching you over sees the stula sharira breathing. Therefore, they know that the person is dreaming or is sleeping, is not dead. Atascha swapne antakarana bahirgatva satyapadarthan vishayikaroti iti etanna sambhavati. So, which is a conclusion of the, since they cannot go outside. Why? Because prana is stuck in the stula sharira. Now, he has an imagined prana. Athava kashchana ratro swapne swasambandhi bhir militaha nana vyavaharan karoti. Now, this is an example which is there in Mandukya, Karika and Bhashya also. Dealt with a little differently. Meaning, all aspects are analyzed here. There, all aspects are not analyzed because they are sufficient in that context. It is swapna mithyatva has to be established. It is sufficient there. So this is an add-on. So if you have studied Mandukya Karika and Bhashya, then this is an add-on to that as to more details are given. That is also necessary. Some details are which are given there are assumed here. Athava kashchana ratrau swapne swasambandhi bhir militaha nana vyavaharan karoti. So let's say somebody dreams about meeting his own relatives and, you know, going on a picnic or whatever with them. Pratar jagranantaram yada tan sambandhinah sakshat pashyati tada vayam ratrau milita abhuma etancha vyavaharan akurma iti vaktum arhati parantu tathana kathayati purva pakshiri ityatu swapna drashta bahirgatavan. So this person who dreamt about, you know, going on a picnic or whatever with his relatives in swapna, when he wakes up, he should say that I went around with my relatives, not that I dreamt. I went around with my relatives yesterday night, and they should agree. He should also say, but they do not recognize this kind of a picnic. They don't know any picnic. They slept very well. This fellow has been dreaming about them. Neither does he waker think that the dream is real. Does not say that we went on a picnic, we did this, I lent you some money, you gave me back. So you laugh in your face if you say I lent you money, you gave me back. That relative is going to, what money, what picnic? Which is very easy to understand for us, but Dvaitins have a trouble there. That is why all this is explained in Mandukya Karika before taking this swapna as an example for Jagrat being mithya. When you say swapnavat mithya, swapna has to be established as mithya. What if the other doesn't agree? There the only basis is tarka. So you have to use tarka to discuss with that person and establish that the swapna is mithya. Otherwise, if you lend money to someone in dream, then he should return to you in jagratavastha. At the most, what will he say? He'll say, I'll return to you in your dream. So in your dreams, that's what it means. give back my money, he'll say, in your dreams. Because it is well known, it is all mithya. But in the case of Puropakshi, what is happening? Puropakshi Rityya tu Swapnadrashta Bhairgatavan, this fellow has gone out, the dreamer. Sambandhinam Drashtavan, he has seen the Sambandhi really, the relatives really. Tena saha Satyarupan Vyavaharanchcha Kritavan, he has done Vyavaharas which are also real. Tatha Paraspara Darshana Vyavaharanchcha. तथा परस्पर दर्शनम व्यवहरणंच संबंधिनः अपि परिज्ञातं भवितुम् अर्हति. सो इट शुड बी नोन टू अदर्स आल्सो. ततश्च संबंधी वा यदा स्वप्नद्रष्टारं पश्यति तदा सोपि तं प्रति वयं स्वप्ने मिलिता व्यवहारान कुर्म इति वक्तुम् अर्हति. परंतु सोपि न तथा वक्ति सिद्धांते तु स्वप्ने बहिर्गमनं संबंधी दर्शनं तेन सह व्यवहरणं सर्वं च अंतरा एव कल्पितम्. So Purvapakshi says that, you know, the Vyavahara is real, the Antakarana went out, it met with real relatives, did real Vyavaharas. In that case, he should also say so, and others should also agree that they had met the earlier day, had done the such Vyavaharas. Let alone think, they don't say such things, they don't think about such things. Parantu saopi. Na tatha vakti. Neither the dreamer nor the relative says that we met. Therefore, what is the siddhanta? Siddhanta is the swapne. Bahirgamanam sambandhi darshanam tenasa vyavaram sarvam cha antarayeva bhavati. It is all within. It is not outside. It is not real. Athava. Other possibility. Swapne bahirgatva satya padarthan pashyati iti angikare. Ratro nidram kuruvataha madhyana surya prakasha darshanam. गंगायाः दक्षिणतटे काशीपुरी दर्शनं काश्याः प्राच्यां दिशि प्रयागक्षेत्रस्य प्रतीच्यां दिशि गयाक्षेत्रस्य दर्शनं च स्वप्ने न भवितुम् उचितम्. नाउ आई विल जस्ट स्पीड थ्रू दिस. इट्स वेल नोन. रात्रौ मध्याह्न सूर्यप्रकाशस्य गंगायाः दक्षिणतटे काशीपुर्याः काश्या प्राच्यां दिशि प्रयागक्षेत्रस्य प्रतीच्यां दिशि गयाक्षेत्रस्य च अभावात्. If somebody dreams about all these kshetras which are mentioned in various directions, whatever is mentioned, one is dreaming at night, but then it is all a daytime activity. Madhyana Surya. So let's go for Mangala Arati in a Devasthana at noon. Let's catch that. So you are going around with everyone and you catch that. However, all that is not possible because it is night. If the mind has traveled outside, it should still be night. You cannot have the mind traveling outside during the night and see Madhyana Surya. So that is the idea, we know that. Tasmat Swapne Jagratyanubhuta Padarthanam Smaranam Bhavati Iti Bahirgateshwara Srishti Girinadyadi Darshanam Bhavati Iti Cha Dvavapi Pakshau Nirakrutau Viditavyau. Therefore, both these objections which Tarkadrishti has raised as to Swapna is real. Why? One, because it is the smaranam of the padarthas in the jagratavastha which are real, or because the antakkarana travels outside and has darshana of Girinadi ityadi which are Ishvara Srishta, which are real, they are not created by you, as the Dvaitin says. That is also not possible. So both pakshas are nirakrita. Jagrat Swapnayoho Tulyata iti Siddhanta Nirupanam. Jagrat and Swapna. Now Swapna is Mithya. Now Jagrat is Swapnavat Mithya. How so? That is described here. Swapne Triputi Samudaya Sarvapi Upajayate. There is a Triputi Samudaya in Swapna also. Just like there is a Jagrat Drashta, Jagrat Drishyam, and Jagrat Darshana. Similarly, there is a Swapna Drashta, Swapna Drishyam, and Swapna Darshanam. All these three are there in Swapna also. Swapne Jagrat Padartha Smritehe Linga Sharira लिंग शरीर बहिर्गमनस्य च असंभवे अपि जागृति इव स्वप्ने अपि ज्ञाता ज्ञानम नियमिति त्रिपुटी भासते. देयर इज अ त्रिपुटी इन देयर इज अ त्रिपुटी आभास इवन इन स्वप्न जस्ट लाइक इट इज देयर इन जागृत बट इट इज एन आभास टू द वेकर टू द ड्रीमर इट इज नॉट एन आभास टू द ड्रीमर इट इज देयर सो भासते त्रिपुटी भासते. Even if the linga sharira does not travel outside, still there is a traveler involved. If you are having a dream of traveling, then you are a traveler. There is a destination because you are reaching that destination. And there is a method to reach there. There is karana also. So karta, karma, karana, tributi is there even in dream, although the antakarana is not traveling outside. Tasmat kanthadastha nadyantara eva. सर्वं उत्पद्यते देयरफॉर वेयरएवर द अंतकरण इज सेटलिंग सो दे से दैट अंतकरण इज इन अ पर्टिकुलर नाडी व्हिच इज इन द दिस कंठादस्थ सो वेयरएवर इज पर्टिकुलर नाडी इज देयर दैट्स अ टेक्निकलिटी वी डोंट केयर मच अबाउट सो वेयरएवर द शास्त्र सेज दैट द अंतकरण द माइंड इज ड्यूरिंग द स्वप्न अवस्था और आत्मा इज प्रेजेंट इन दैट एरिया दैट इज स्थान कंठस्थान स्वप्न इन स्वप्न दि जीवा इज इन कंठ वट एवर इज एक्सप्रेस देयर वी एग्री ओके शास्त्र सेज दैट आई डोंट नो मच अबाउट वट एवर इट इज वी डोंट रियली इट डजंट मैटर इट डजंट चेंज दैट सर्वम अंतरा उत्पद्यते इट इज ऑल विद इन वेदर इट इज इन कंठस्थान और यू नो इन दि दक्षिण चक्षु इज इरिलेवेंट टू दि conclusion the conclusion it is within it is not outside ayam artha mandukya brahadaranyakadishu suchitah it is there in both mandukya and brahadaranyaka upanishad swapna sthana antah prajnya sa yatra praswapityasya lokasya sarvavato matram apadaya swayam vihatya swayam nirmaya swena bhasa swena jyotisha praswapiti atrayam purusha swayam jyotir bhavati so swayam jyoti brahmana In Brahadaranyaka and Mandukya Upanishad says that Swapna Sthanah Antah Prajnah. This Swapna Sthanah is the Jiva who is called as Taijasa, who has Swapna as his Sthana. That is Swapna Sthanah, who is Antah Prajnah. His Prajna is within. That is what Mandukya Upanishad says. So it is all within, it is not outside. Purupakshi said that it is outside, nothing is outside, it is all within. इन स्वप्नावस्था सह यत्र प्रस्वपिति अस्य लोकस्य सर्वावतः मात्राम् आपादाय स्वयं विहत्य स्वयं निर्माय स्वेन भासा स्वेन ज्योतिषा प्रस्वपिति ही स्लीप्स एंड ही हैज दर्शन हैज स्वप्न ऑफ व्हाट ही हैज विथ हिज ओन द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड इज विथड्रॉन एंड देन विथ हिज ओन भासा हैविंग क्रिएटेड हैविंग गिवन अप एवरीथिंग एल्स He rejoices in his own creation. Atrayam purusha swayam jyotir bhavati. There is no external jyoti needed to light up the world. The world is lit up by his swayam jyoti, his own jyoti. Sakshi bhasya. Na tatratha nartha yogan panthanu bhavanti. Atratha nartha yogan patasrijyate. So patasrijyate. The path, all these ratha. There is, if the ratha is there in the dream, And there are paths for this ratha to go on, chariots to go on. None of them are there. Nothing of the sort is really there. It is all created in the dream. Ayam artha. What is the meaning of these mantras? So mantras may be a little complicated to analyze. So he gives the artha. What is this? Because vyakarana may be different. The context may be not clear. Because just picking one mantra off randomly, you cannot make sense out of it. Not all the time. Therefore, ayam artha. What is the idea? Na jagrat kalinaha padartha supne bhanti kintu ratha ratika ashwa margadayaha. So ratha ratika ashwa margadayaha. The charioteer, all the travelers and the horses, the paths, all these are not the jagrat kalina padarthas. They are all created. Sarve api supne abhinavasta tatkala. Abhinavaha tatkala. So abhinavas tatkala is abhinavaha tatkala. They are all new. They are not the same as the old jagrat avastha. जागृत अवस्था पदार्थ दे आर ऑल न्यूली क्रिएटेड सो अभिनवाः तत्काल एव सृज्यन्ते इति दे आर ऑल क्रिएटेड तत्काल मैनिफेस्टेड बट क्रिएशन इज इन द सेंस ऑफ मैनिफेस्टेशन वी नो दैट द वर्ड्स आर इंटरचेंजेबल बिकॉज ऑफ यू नो लैक ऑफ अ बेटर वर्ड इन इंग्लिश सृज्यन्ते दे आर ऑल देयर क्रिएटेड बाय द माइंड कल्पिता बाय द माइंड मैनिफेस्ट बाय द माइंड तस्मात् स्वप्ने उपलभ्यमानः गिरी नदी समुद्र वनग्राम पट्टण सूर्य चंद्रादय सर्वे अपि नूतना उत्पद्यन्ते सो देयर इज एन उत्पत्ति व्हाट काइंड ऑफ उत्पत्ति सेम उत्पत्ति एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर कल्पना कल्पित उत्पत्ति ऑल उत्पत्ति इज कल्पित बट वी आर नॉट लुकिंग एट द जागृत अवस्था येट इट इज नॉट अंडरस्टूड बाय तर्क दृष्टि सो व्हाट इज अवर क्वेश्चन Swapna is mithya, you establish that. Then you extend it to Jagrata Avastha. Swapna is mithya. It is Swapna Padarthas are mithya because they don't, the Antakkarana Indriyas do not travel outside. That was established. Now it is said it is all within. And what is within? How can it be real? Because Parvata cannot be within. Look at your body and look at the Parvata that the dreamer, you as a dreamer saw. This is a Mandukya process. Uchita Desha Kala is not there. That is the idea. Uchita Desha Kala is not there for whatever you saw in that dream. You cannot have lived 1 year. If you dreamt of living 1 year, it felt like a year, but you slept only for a small duration of time. Kala is not Uchita for that long a duration. So it is for that long a, an activity, that long a life, segment of life. So Uchita Desha is lacking. Uchita Kala is lacking. Uchita Desha is lacking because in the Antakkarana you cannot have Ratha, Parvata, Ityadi. You have difficulty to climb a Ratha and a mount and a Giri also. How can you have Ratha and Giri within? Uchita Desha is not there, very obvious. But you have to use Tarka and establish it. Why is it Mithya? Because Uchita Desha, Uchita Kala is not there. So Nutana Utpadyante, within they are newly created. Yadi Swapne Parvatadeha Na Utpadyante, Tarhi Tesham Pratyaksha Jnanam Swapne Na Utpattum Arhati. Is there Swapna Jnanotpatti? In Swapna is there Jnanotpatti? Yes. If Jnanotpatti is there, then these Padarthas have to have Utpatti in Swapna. Jayate Tu Tesham Swapne Pratyaksha Jnanam. So Pratyaksha Jnana is there. You cannot say it is a smriti. You know that it is pratyaksha jnana. A dreamer knows that, oh, pratyaksha gajaha asti atra. Oh, look at the beautiful mountain. Not that, you know, I recollect a beautiful mountain. Therefore, swapnika, the swapna darshana karta, swapna drashta, definitely has pratyaksha jnana of parvata ityadi, giri samudra ityadi. Therefore, there has to be Giri Samudra Utpatti. Visheena sa indriyana antakkarana vrittesha sambandha pratyaksha jnane hetuhu. If pratyaksha jnana has been accepted, it has been established already. So whether you accept or not is irrelevant to the Siddhanta. Siddhantin says that, do you have pratyaksha jnana? He says, no, I have smriti. That has been refuted. Now the smriti is not there. Did you cognize something? Yes. That cognition is pratyaksha to you as a dreamer. If it is pratyaksha, then how can you have not have padartha outside? The padartha for the dreamer is outside. And in the waking, it is in the mind. Therefore, there is padartha utpatti, which leads to pratyaksha jnanotpatti. And pratyaksha jnanotpatti, what is the hetu for pratyaksha jnana? Vishaya has to be connected with the indriya, then only you can have pratyaksha jnana. So pratyaksha jnane hetuhu sambandha. There is a connection. What is the connection between vishayena saha indriyanam antakkarana vrittescha sambandha? The connection is of the indriyas and antakkarana vritti with the vishayas, just like it is there in waking state. So jagradvat pratyaksha jnane hetuhu visheena saha indriyanam antakkarana vrittescha sambandha. That is there in swapna also. Therefore, what? You have to have vishayas, Because pratyaksha jnana is there, you should have vishaya, indriyas, antakarana, all these have to be there. So triputi is established. Tasmat parvatadaya vishaya, tasmat parvatadayo vishaya, tanjnana sadhana antakaranena, sadhana sadhana tats. Sorry, let me just correct it. Tasmat parvatadaya vishaya, tanjnana sadhana antakarana indriyadikam sarvam api. Antarautpadyante. So all this is born inside. Within the antakarna vishaya, parvatadi vishayas, then tadjnana is parvatadi jnana sadhana. So there is parvata outside for the dreamer, but it is inside for the waker, from the waker's perspective. Then jnana is also there. Jnana is anyway taking place in the antakarna. For the dreamer also, for the waker also. So jnana sadhana, from both perspectives, there is jnana. And then sadhana is also there. Sadhana, which is that jnana sadhana, antakarna and indriya. All of these, whatever is necessary. Basically samagri, pratyaksha jnana samagri is there. Sarvam api antara utpadyante. From the waker's perspective, it is there in the antakarna. ननु स्वप्न पदार्थ शुक्ति रजतादिवत साक्षिभास्याः अतः तज्ज्ञाने अंतकरण इंद्रियाणाम उपयोगो नास्ति. So to this there is a पूर्वपक्ष. An objection is that प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान you are claiming to be in स्वप्न. For that you need अंतकरण इत्यादि. Now स्वप्न पदार्थ शुक्ति रजतादिवत साक्षिभास्याः. स्वप्न is within. That much you have also agreed. It is not outside. In fact, this is your argument. Siddhanti's argument is that the antakarana does not travel outside. That is what you have done in the earlier section. Now you are saying that swapnavat jagrat mithya. That's why you are saying swapna padartha. You are saying swapna also has triputi, just like jagrat has triputi. Swapna padarthas are there. Karta, swapna drashta is there. And the darshana sadhana is there. So you are bringing antakarana and indriyas there also. However, it is sakshibhasya. Shukti rajata, just like the silver seen in the place of nekar, the shell. Similarly, sapna is seen. It is not seen by everyone else. The silver is seen by whoever sees it. The others see shell. So just like in the bhranti sthala, sapna sthala also, sakshi alone is the witness. There is no antakarana vritti, all that. Why are you talking about antakarana vritti taking place and then, you know, there being a triputi? These indriyas are all not necessary because it is sakshi bhasya. Like a Brahma. In Brahma, there is no indriya travel. There is no antakarana vritti taking place outside. It is avidya vritti. So, swapna should also be like that. Why do you bring in this triputi? That is the question. Puro Pakshyas. Nanu swapna padartha shukti rajatadivat sakshi bhasyaha bhavanti tat ataha. Tajnane antakarana indriyana upayogo nasti. Antakarana and indriyas have no play in a bhranti. Similarly, they should have no play in the swapnavastha. Tasmat swapne jnayanam parvatadinam utpatyangi karasya uchitatve api jnatru jnana yur indriyanam cha utpatyangi karo na uchitaiti chen. Answer is no. So this is not a pura. No, is an answer. If the question we ask that even if Neya Parvatas, Vishayas are accepted to be there, but how do you say Jnatru and Jnana, which are needed in the Triputi? Triputi is Neya, Jnatru and Jnana. Neya is accepted because even if you accept Neya, other two are not established. You cannot land on Triputi. You say Vishayas are there, Neya Vishayas are there in Swapna, I agree. But Jnatru Jnana, where do you get this? For Triputi, where do you get these two? They are not there. You cannot accept them because their upyoga is not there in Sakshi. In Sakshi Bhasya Padarthas. So, Padarthas are there. Now, if you say even if they are there, so it can be like, you know, there is a Shukti outside. So, Shukti Padartha is there. But is Rajata there? It isn't there. So, you can say in Swapna also, maybe Shuktivat Parvatadis are there. Which are real, you can say real, unreal, I don't care. But then, Nyaya can be established by you with your argument. You cannot establish the Nyatru and Jnana. Nyatru Jnana, Nyatni Jnana yo Indriyanam cha Utpatyangi karaha na uchita. That is not right. Why so? Why is it not right? Yatha sopne parvatadeha pratiyante tatha indriyani antakkaranam pranasahita stula shariram cha iti etanyapi pratiyante tasmat tesham sarvesham utpatti angikarya eva. So yatha sopne parvatadeha pratiyante, just like the sopna prapancha is seen, similarly indriyas antakkarana pranasahita stula sharira also, they are also, there is a pratiti of everything, not only just the swapna vishayas. To a dreamer, swapna vishayas are cognized, but he also knows himself. He knows that I am the cognizer. He knows that I have these indriyas. He may or may not have 20-20 eyesight. He may need spectacles. He may need contact lenses. He is hearing something. He is tasting something. So there is not only the padarthas, but to interact with the padarthas, you need somebody who is the interactor, and you need a mechanism to interacting. And all those, I am not deriving them. This is not, through anumana. It is pratyaksha. Just like padartha is pratyaksha, the dreamer has padarthas which are known through pratyaksha jnana. Why? Because it is pratyaksha to him. Not only are the padarthas pratyaksha, if he says, I am seeing the padartha, he knows that he is the seer. So, the seer is also pratyaksha to him. The vishaya is pratyaksha to him. And the means by which he sees is also pratyaksha. He does not say that, I don't know how I am seeing this parvata. I don't have eyes. He knows that eyes are there. He does not say that, I am seeing them through my ears. He knows that I am seeing through my eyes. So, eyes are pratyaksha to him. And he knows that he is seeing, therefore, he is also pratyaksha to him. So, jnatru jnana yoho indriyanam cha utpatyangikara na uchita. If you say, if there is no utpatti of them, then how did they come about there? Because the jnatru is sleeping in the bed. You cannot say that the sleeper jnatru is not present there. Someone else is present, so utpatti has to be accepted for the jnata also. Jnana also, just like the jnaya, utpatti has to be accepted. Athava, otherwise, I'll just take 5 more minutes. We started late, so I would like to get some pace here. Athava swapna padarthanam netradi vishayata pratiyate. So swapna padartham netradi vishayata pratiyate. Swapna padarthas are netra vishayas. Do you agree? Yes, they are netra vishayas. You cannot say that they are not netra vishayas in the dream just because it is a dream. To the dreamer, in the dream, during the dream, swapna padarthas are netra vishayas. Shrotra Vishayas, Indriya Vishayas, they are Indriya Vishayas, Netradi, Adipadena, all other Indriyas. Vyavaharika Netradi Vishayata, Swapna Pratibhasika Padarthanam Nagatate. Now you cannot say that Vishayas are there, which are Pratibhasika in Swapna, but I am using my Vyavaharika Indriyas, therefore I do not need Indriyas in the dream. You cannot say that. Vyavaharika Netradi Vishayata, Swapna Pratibhasika Padarthanam Nagatate. You cannot take along your waking Indriyas into the dream. One may not be, see, imagine this. I mean, I had inquired with others also. The doctors also agree that a blind person, a child who was born blind, bereft of eyes, also has a dream. If the Chakshur Indriya is not working in the waking state, how is it working in the dream state? That is why it is possible to teach a child as to, somebody who is unable to see, they also are taught, how to interact with the world, what does the eye see outside? They can be taught because they have some anubhava. In Swapna, they have some anubhava of seeing. So they can somehow relate to it, that this is what happens in waking. Unfortunately, they can't see in the waking state. Those indriyas are not working in the dream. Otherwise, a person would be as blind as he is in waking. I may need spectacles in waking state, but in dream I may not wear spectacles and see, because indriyas are are not waking indriyas. By the way, someone who has studied Chandogya may recall, I think in Chandogya Upanishad 6th chapter it is there. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says the indriyas are subtle. To drive home the point, he says that indriyas are those indriyas through which you dream. You cognize in the dream. So to drive home the subtlety, that those are the indriyas. Meaning in Swapna also indriyas are there. They may not be the same indriyas, but indriyas are those subtle things through which you dream as well. You cognize the dream. Samasattaka padarthayor eva parasparam sadaka badakata asti iti panchama tarange nirupitatvat. So Sadhu is saying that I will not go into details because it has been established in the fifth chapter itself, fifth taranga, as to samasattaka padartha themselves alone can have sadaka badaka bhava. You cannot have sadhaka bhadaka bhava. Here sadhaka bhava. Here sadhaka bhava is that I can use my indriyas to see swapna. Which indriyas? It cannot be the indriya from a different satta. It has to be from the same satta. So pratibhasika sattaka indriya is needed for pratibhasika sattaka vishaya. So you have to agree that there is pratibhasika sattaka indriyas in the dream also. You have to accept their utpatti also. Tathacha vyavaharika netradinam sharire vidyamanatvepi tesham vishamasattakatvat tajjanya jnana vishayatvam swapna padarthanam na sambhavet. You cannot cognize with the vyavaharika indriyas in swapna. So we'll see the rest from the third in the next part. सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्णयं अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्तोन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. नमस्ते. एनी क्वेश्चंस? नमस्ते. आई विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट.
हरि ओम.
नमस्ते.